Hi everyone, welcome to CAAPID Simplified. I am Nourah and I'm here with Karthik on the other side of the camera. This is our first video after we had our webinar yesterday, and that went pretty good. I'm going to be talking about some of the most important resources that I used and we researched about that you could use in your process of becoming an international dentist in the United States. So the first ever thing, we start off with national boards. And now that we know that we are moving towards integrated national boards, it's the same thing, but it's part one and part two combined. The resources that you can use to prepare for national boards would be dental decks, first aid, and Facebook is a very important resource which I used. You could find a buddy to work with, just post that you want to find somebody you can study with, and you can find someone. I know I worked with someone and it was really helpful. And you can also use it as a forum where you can ask questions, and you can also learn from the answers that other people have posted. So that would be the resources that I would recommend for national boards. When it comes to applying for CAAPID, some of the resources that you could use to really learn about the process would be start with ADEA-PASS. They have a lot of resources about which schools can give you this international course, how many students do they take per year, when do you start applying, what is the deadline, and what are their requirements. So you can look at all of that. But if you want a more detailed explanation of some things that are given on that page, then you can definitely come to our page, CAAPID Simplified, where we have separate articles that we wrote, especially curated towards this admission process. Another page that I really like is Alyssa Marshall's International Dentist Central. She also has some valuable articles that you can look at if you don't understand some of the terms that they've mentioned in ADEA-PASS. Now when it comes to improving your profile, I can give you some of the resources that I used. So conferences. Conferences that hold a lot of value, but you can also get in by not sharing a lot out of your pocket, would be ADA Meet, the American Dental Association's annual dental meet, Yankee Dental Congress in Boston, the Greater New York Dental Meeting that happens in New York every year, the Chicago Midwinter Meeting, and you can also find conferences where you can present by just paying very little for the registration fee through conferenceseries.com. These are some of the resources that I would use. And for CE, a lot of people asked me where we can find continuing education courses. Some of the websites that I use for online continuing education would be dentalcare.com, and dentalcare.ca is also another website that's actually for Canada, but you can find different courses. If you're bored with the courses that you've already done in dentalcare.com, you can go ahead and do it over there. And if you're willing to do longer courses that are extended over a week or something like that, you can go to EDX. EDX is also a very useful resource. Now, volunteering, where can you find volunteering opportunities? Start with volunteer match, where you give your location and what you're interested in, and they just give you a list of opportunities that you can sign up for. You don't have to necessarily be in the dental field, but you can also enroll in food banks, hospice, you can go to children's daycare or elderly home where you don't really have to work a lot, but you can use that time for applications or studying, but you're still adding on to your volunteering hours. And now that we have built our profile, we're going to move towards interviews and bench, because each one of you who's watching this video is definitely going to have one. So for interview, I would say the best resource that you can find would be CAAPID Simplified's Interview Ultimate Compendium, because that was compiled by both of us based on my preparation and his preparation, and it's very exhaustive. You can look at every single question that you can come across. And other resources that we would recommend is on YouTube. There's Linda Rainier for behavioral questions, and another resource is Amazon's 14 Leadership Principles. There you can learn about some qualities that you can talk about or demonstrate that's very, very valuable when it comes to personality testing. For statement of purpose, statement of purpose, you can learn a lot about it from CAAPID Simplified and also from International Dental Central. Now, when it comes to bench exams, I would suggest that you have a lot of practice and take a course if you need to. But if you want to start off, you want to start off by looking at some resources on YouTube maybe. On YouTube, Stevenson Health Solutions is very good. They have free videos and they cover most of the practices that we do. So you can look at them. And if you do go to schools like SIU, where they ask about surveying, then you can look at Anne Vinci. She has a separate page, especially for RPD survey and designing, and she's extremely helpful. She even helped me with some design charts where I could practice and work for my exam. So that was very helpful. So that was all I had for you guys today. I hope that was helpful. Please feel free to reach out to us if you have any questions about these resources. And if you missed out on any of these in the video, you can scroll below and we have links to each of this in the comment section. Thank you.